Hi, I'm Mike Dano with Light Reading, and I'm here with Iyad from Federated Wireless. Thanks for joining us today. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Mike. Appreciate it.
Yeah. And so Federated has been very busy lately. I think that's fair to say.
Yes, definitely.
You've made announcements about a spectrum exchange. You're very busy in the CBRS networks that work in the CBRS spectrum band and operating the spectrum access system there. Another area that Federated Wireless is involved in is the 6 gigahertz band.
Absolutely.
Okay. And there's a new technology in the 6 gigahertz band called AFC.
Yes.
So maybe you could tell us a little bit about what that technology does.
Sure.
And what Federated is doing in that band.
Great. Thank you.
Yeah.
Maybe a bit of education, a little bit background. There is a new band for Wi-Fi 6. It's the 6 gigahertz. It's 1200 megahertz. A portion of it, a very big portion of it, will be available for Wi-Fi 6. That is about speed, about performance, about automation, all the things you want to see with Wi-Fi. And Wi-Fi 6 is built to advance the cause of enterprise networks, and this spectrum is a very big enabler of that. We started back in 2018, working on with the FCC, with simulations and modeling and collaborative work. Same thing we did with CBRS. Mm-hmm. If you remember in CBRS, it took us about 5 years working with the Navy to see, hey, how do we coexist? How do we make this good for everyone? We did the same thing for 6 gigahertz. We spent about 3 years doing simulations, talking to the carrier business, talking to the operators that are using some of this band already, utilities, other public interested parties. And what we ended up with is this, in the regulatory process, is this simplified version of the spectrum controller. Hmm. That spectrum controller in Wi-Fi, in 6 gigahertz, which is actually more than Wi-Fi, can be used for 5G as well. Hmm. It is called an AFC, an automatic frequency controller. So a lot of jargons, a lot of new names, but these are becoming more popular. At the time, we thought it would only be used by a very small minority of use cases. Outdoor, enterprise, high power.
In the 6 gigahertz band.
In the 6 gigahertz band, mostly for Wi-Fi. Said, you know, that's still useful. That's a lot of spectrum. Let's make sure we make it useful. What we found out in the last 60, 90 days as we have been working with different partners is that there is a lot of interest in using it for indoor. Hmm. And indoor is the primary use case for Wi-Fi, as you know. And it's not just enterprise, it's consumer as well. And so I started poking around, why? Why are we getting all this interest? And the reason is pretty simple. If you use an AFC, you get 6 times the power. And so how many people here have this meshing thing for Wi-Fi? Yep. I've got one, I can't even make it work. I'm not alone, I'm pretty sure.
I have never made one work, I'll tell you that.
More power is good, yeah. More power is less antenna, more power is less hardware. So we've announced a couple of weeks ago, as we've talked before, a partnership with HPE. HPE is our first customer for this product, which is the AFC that we worked on, and we're gonna work together to make the system work, not just in the US, but globally. The regulatory process happens to start just about in a month. Mm-hmm. End of November is the deadline for us and anybody else who's interested to be in this business to submit proposals to the FCC, say, hey, I want to do an AFC, I want to make sure I enable the industry. We're obviously, this is our business, we're going to be there no matter what, we're going to make it happen. And we've got the product. The product's already working. It builds on all the infrastructure, all the scale, all the performance, all the SLAs, all the interoperability, all the knowledge, all the industry connections that we've done already with the spectrum controller. It's very natural for us. We have the product. And then we expect maybe about 3 months of testing and work with the FCC, very similar to the spectrum controller, except much faster. And so sometime early to mid next year, you're going to start beginning to see these 6 times the power devices on Wi-Fi 6 using an AFC. And that will be revolutionary for the Wi-Fi ecosystem.
Yeah.
It's called Wi-Fi 6E,
you would put
just for the name.
Inside of a location like this one, like the LA Convention Center, in an indoor scenario, and use the AFC coordination to increase the amount of bandwidth that's available?
Or power.
Power. Okay.
So what the AFC does is protects the incumbents. Remember, in the CBRS band, we protect the Navy and we protect each other by having a coordinated system. Think of it as a brain with algorithms that watches everybody, makes sure everybody knows where they are in the spectrum and how to make sure not to interfere with their neighbors. The AFC does the same thing. Mm-hmm. But in this case, the incumbents are not the Navy. They are utilities. They are backhaul for cell sites. Mm-hmm. They are connections to some enterprises over microwave. About 30% of the band is used up with incumbents. Mm-hmm. They're obviously important. They have mission-critical applications. We have to protect them. So what the FCC did is rules. It said, hey, if you can't use an AFC that can see everything and coordinate everything, then you can't go too much power. But if you use an AFC, the AFC will tell you where to go in the band. I mean, 1,200 is a lot of spectrum.
Right.
So a coordination there is even simpler because there's a lot of swap space that we can give people. But now we know that if you use an AFC, you're going to protect the incumbents, which is our job. Our job is to give people the best spectrum they can for the best performance they can do the most with it, and do it. We're going to do it in our model that we've always done. It's APIs, it's cloud-based, it's through a partner ecosystem, it's through collaboration with the OEMs, it's working with our customers, working with the FCC, working with everybody. And it's very exciting because we went from a very marginal case to this thing that has a lot of value.
Right, exactly.
I would give a lot of money for not having to deal with meshing at the home. I can tell you that.
And it's,
now,
and you said
I know some people can make it work. I just can't.
And you said it's for outdoor applications as well as indoor applications.
Yes, both indoor and outdoor,
the power.
Enterprise and consumer.
Gotcha.
And then as of late, we're beginning to find out that it has value outside the U.S., which is also another, you know, another good thing.
Yeah, exactly. Very interesting. All right. Ian, thanks so much for joining us today. Really appreciate it.
Thank you so much. Yeah. Bye. Bye-bye.